Welcome back to Building Character, where we figure out how to play as your favorite fictional characters in Dungeons & Dragons. Remember to vote in the poll and like and subscribe for hotter characters next time you play. Maybe. Today we're building Johnny Storm, also known as the Human Torch. If Sue is the heart of the group, Ben is the muscle, and Reed is the brain, that leaves Johnny to be the face. And just because that face is on fire doesn't mean it's not hot enough to get the job done. Just the opposite, in fact.
Flame on.
Let's start off with our goals for this build. First, fire. Lots of fire. Fire good enough to burn through things that fire shouldn't go through. Next, we need the power of flight. That's levitation, Holmes. Finally, we'll make sure that we've got a smoldering smile, even without cosmic powers. For stats, we're using the standard point array from the player's handbook. Roll for stats if that's your thing. I'm not gonna come to your house and break all your most valued possessions. Probably not anyways. Charisma will be number one. It's your casting modifier and your ticket to space, because really, there are so many more people more qualified than you to make that trip. Dexterity next. Flying requires sharp turns and your armor is skin tight. Constitution after that, Johnny can take a punch from Namor and that dude can lift. Follow that up with intelligence. I know I just said that he charmed his way onto the rocket, but he is actually a great mechanic. Strength is a bit low. You're in decent shape. We just don't really need it, but we'll dump wisdom. You're a literal hothead. Your lack of self-control is kind of an issue. The Human Torch is a variant human because it's in the name, and Torch isn't a race in D&D. Because I know people kind of get sick of the variant human, imagine if Johnny was a tiefling. You'd get Hellish Rebuke, resist fire damage right away, and have horns to physically demonstrate a personal characteristic. You wouldn't be able to get a feat at the first level, but really, this build doesn't need them that much? Elemental Adept may seem like the obvious pick here, but we're actually going to get all of those bonuses with a later subclass. So grab the Resilient feat to get a bonus to your Dexterity, as well as proficiency with Dexterity saving throws. Bump your Charisma and your Constitution with your 2 free points, take Acrobatics for your skill of choice, and the Guild Artisan background for Persuasion and Insight proficiency, as well as Smith's Tools proficiency. Swap out your Extra Language for a Land Vehicle proficiency so that you can drive the cars you're fixing. Kick things off as a Sorcerer. You can grab 2 skills from the Sorcerer list. Deception and Intimidation would be my picks. For your subclass, Pyromancer is from the Plane Shift Kaldesh Unearth Arcana, free with a quick Google search. You get Heart of Fire, meaning that when you cast spells of first level or higher that deal fire damage, you can deal fire damage equal to half your sorcerer level to creatures of your choice within 10 feet of you. That is of your choice, so don't worry, you don't have to roast your sister or her nerdy boyfriend. Use spells like Burning Hands. It forces a Dexterity saving throw on creatures in a 15-foot cone, dealing 3d6 fire damage to those that fail and half to those that succeed. Basically a little mini flamethrower that can roast any Doombots that get too close. Mage armor will make your AC 13 plus your Dexterity modifier for a minute if you're not wearing armor. That whole body coating fire thing does prevent a lot of things from hitting you. For your cantrips, Firebolt is a ranged spell attack, dealing 1d10 fire damage, and it ignites flammable objects that aren't being worn or carried. Light creates a bright light if you need to see in the dark. Create Bonfire creates a 5-foot area of fire, dealing 1d8 fire damage to creatures inside that fail a Dexterity save. And Control Flames lets you do some roleplay stuff to fire, expanding it, changing the color of the flame, making it brighter or dimmer, things like that. It's not going to deal any damage, but could impress someone at a bar. Second level sorcerers get a Font of Magic with sorcery points you can use to recover spell slots, but thanks to the fancy new class feature variants on Unearthed Arcana, you can also spend 2 sorcery points to use Empowered Reserves for advantage on 1 skill check, Imbuing Touch to make a weapon magical for a minute, not Imbibing Touch like I said in the Bowser video. I must have been imbibing a bit too much. That's a joke, I actually don't drink. Sorcerer's Fortitude lets you give yourself temporary HP equal to 1d4 for every sorcery point you spend. If you think Super Scroll is going to be punching you sometime soon, maybe stock up. For this level, Spell Shield lets you add 5 to your AC as a reaction. Again, all that fire should make you a bit more defensive. Third level sorcerers can get a little more offensive options with Scorching Ray. This lets you create 3 small fireballs that deal 2d6 fire damage each. You can use these to make a ranged spell attack against one or multiple enemies. Each one is a new attack roll. Thankfully, your best stat also happens to be your casting modifier. What a surprise. You can also use Meta Magic to augment your spells with sorcery points. Careful Spell lets you choose a number of creatures equal to your Charisma modifier to automatically pass your spell saves. Considering the Fantastic Four is the first family of Marvel, it would be a bit awkward if you accidentally killed one of your family members. Empowered Spell lets you reroll a number of damage die on a spell equal to your Charisma modifier. Both of those only cost 1 sorcery point and can be helpful when you've got a really huge area of effect spell. Fourth level sorcerers get an ability score improvement. You've got to cap your Charisma as soon as possible possible for maximum saves on your spells. Speaking of, Agonizer's Scorcher is a second level spell that creates a 30-foot line of fire, forcing dexterity saves on creatures and dealing 3d8 fire damage to those that fail. This is more of a straight shot of fire for when your enemies are nice enough to stand in a straight line. 5th level sorcerers can learn 3rd level spells, and Fireball is the textbook spell for fire damage. The designers of 5e have admitted it's kinda busted, so yeah, it's pretty good. Forces a dexterity save on creatures in a 20-foot radius sphere, dealing 8d6 fire damage to those that fail, and half to those that succeed. Remember to protect your team from it, though I'm realizing your team's actually pretty great at handling that. Sue's got defensive tools, Reed is literally made out of rubber, and Ben is basically indestructible. But you know, careful spells, just consider it. 6th level pyromancers have fire in their veins, letting them resist fire damage and ignore resistances to fire damage with spells they cast, which basically covers the whole point of taking that elemental adept feat I mentioned earlier. For your spell this level, Fly lets you fly, giving you a flying speed of 60 feet for up to 10 minutes depending on your concentration. Keep that in mind, if you lose concentration and you're 100 feet up, you're gonna fall hard and fast, so be careful. It's not really in character for you, but hey, I tried. 7th level sorcerers learn 4th level spells. Wall of Fire creates a wall of fire that's 60 feet long and 20 feet high, or a ringed wall 20 feet in diameter. It forces a dexterity saving throw, dealing 5d8 fire damage to those that fail, half to those that succeed, and deals that damage on subsequent turns to any creature that ends their turn within 10 feet of a side of the wall of your choosing. Lasts for a minute depending on your concentration, so no flying and firewalling at the same time, unfortunately. 8th level sorcerers get an ability score improvement, letting you cap your charisma for maximum spell saves. For this level's spell, pick up Pyrotechnics from the 2nd level, letting you make some fireworks to blind creatures that fail a constitution saving throw in a 10-foot radius, or to create smoke in a 20-foot radius that obscures the area for a minute. Not all your fire needs to deal damage, and this gives you some more options to make things a little more interesting than just fireball until everyone stops moving. 9th level sorcerers can learn 5th level spells. Immolation forces a dexterity save on a creature, dealing 8d6 fire damage to those that fail, and another 4d6 every turn they fail a dexterity save on the following turns, for up to a minute depending on your concentration. Again, this means you can't fly with this spell going, but it can straight up melt someone with fireballs on subsequent turns. 10th level sorcerers get another meta magic option. Heightened spell costs 3 sorcery points and forces disadvantage on a spell save, so make sure your fireball is fully roasting someone. 11th level sorcerers can learn 6th level spells. Investiture of Flames wraps your body in fire. For the duration, you're immune to fire damage, resist cold damage, creatures ending their turn within 10 feet of you take 1d10 fire damage, and you can use your action to create a 15-foot line of fire that deals 4d8 fire damage to creatures that fail a dexterity save after those that succeed. Finally, after 11 levels, we can officially say, fire on. Flame go? Shoot, what's his catchphrase? Clobberin' time. 12th level sorcerers get another ability score improvement. Concentration is a thing you do, so why not invest in Constitution? It'll also give you some more HP and make you less of a squishy caster. 13th level sorcerers can learn 7th level spells, and I actually held off at 10th level because I wanted to take 2 spells here. You can swap out your spells on level up, so you don't actually have to do that. Heck with that new class variance on Earth Arcana, you can actually swap out 1 spell per long rest even. But whatever. Firestorm lets you create 10 10-foot cubes that deal 7d10 fire damage to creatures that fail a dexterity saving throw inside those squares, half to those that succeed. Each cube has to touch another one, but that's not a huge deal when you've got 10 of them. It shouldn't really be an issue. If that's not quite your speed, you could take Delayed Blast Fireball, which basically lets you charge up a fireball for up to a minute. Starts off dealing 12d6 fire damage to creatures that fail a dexterity save in a 20-foot radius, adding another d6 for every round you store it up, meaning if you hold concentration for the whole duration, it can deal 22d6 damage. While you're holding that concentration, there's a small bead glowing at the point you plan to detonate it. That can be detonated early if you end your concentration, or if somebody touches it and fails a dexterity save. This is almost a supernova level of heat, but we've actually got something more intense coming. 14th level pyromancers get Pyromancer's Fury, letting you deal fire damage equal to your sorcerer level with a reaction to anyone who hits you with a melee attack. Being wreathed in fire should be a pretty good deterrent to people actually getting close, but maybe they heard you have a sorcerer hit die and think you're easy to kill. 15th level sorcerers can learn 8th level spells. Incendiary Cloud creates a 20-foot radius cloud of smoke that deals 10d8 fire damage to creatures inside that fail a dexterity save, half to those that succeed. Stays up for a full minute and pushes 10 feet away from you each turn, but ends early if you lose concentration. Let's say your sister has the spell Hold Person, because she does. That would prevent a person from moving and make them automatically fail their dex saves, so they'd take 100d8 fire damage. I'm told that's a lot. 16th level sorcerers get another ability score improvement. More constitution will make you harder to kill and help you keep yourself in the air or keep your perpetual fire spells burning. 17th level sorcerers can learn 9th level spells. Meteor Swarm is the biggest, baddest fire spell you can cast, forcing a dexterity save on creatures in 4 40-foot radius spheres, dealing 20d6 fire damage and 20d6 bludgeoning damage to those that fail and half to those that succeed. This is your full-on supernova flame. The bludgeoning damage, just a nice bonus. 18th level pyromancers get Fiery Soul, making you fully immune to fire damage. All of your fire spells ignore resistances, and if a creature is fully immune to fire damage, you treat immunity as resistance. Basically, you burn so hot that you can burn fire elementals, which are literally made of fire. 19th level sorcerers get our last ability score improvement. Capping off your constitution would be good, but some more dexterity wouldn't be bad either. For AC to possibly avoid damage altogether, it's really up to you. Our capstone is the 20th level of sorcerer, giving you sorceress restoration, so that you can recover 4 sorcery points every short rest. Honestly, as far as capstones go, this one's pretty weak, but you also now have 20 sorcery points every long rest, so you can meta magic pretty much every spell in some way. Now that we've hit level 20, let's figure out how viable this build is. First, you've got amazing fire damage. Immolation, Fireball, Incendiary Cloud, and Meteor Strike all have fantastic health bar melting properties. You also never have to worry about resistances and barely have to worry about full immunity. Finally, you can fly, and flying is always useful. Well, not always, but pretty regularly. For weaknesses, even if immunity and resistance aren't an issue, dexterity saves are. Anything with the evasion ability is going to be really hard for you to kill. You'll have to whittle them down with Firebolts or Scorching Rays. You're also lacking in several ability scores. Strength, Intelligence, and Wisdom specifically could have you on the nasty end of some harsh saving throws. Finally, despite the solid concentration you have, you've just got an abundance of concentration spells, meaning you gotta pick and choose what you're using. But don't concentrate on that. Burn everything in your way and sculpt your spells to make sure the other members of your team are safe. Just watch out if you're going against other casters. Intense spell saves could mean you're doomed. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, subscribe for more. We make 2 videos every week. Vote in the poll for She-Ra, Catra, or Intrapida from Netflix's She-Ra. And check out my other channel, where I do longer Let's Plays for more Tulok fun.